Next on the list of animals to see was the bird aviary. As they walked into the bird aviary, there were all kinds of birds to be seen. Canaries, who sang a lot. Parrots, who croaked a lot. Budgerigars, who people have sometimes at home in cages. But of all various different colours. And many other types of birds that came from warm countries. Lawrence asked his father why there were not any sparrows or blackbirds in the bird aviary. Mr. Teddy explained that sparrows and blackbirds and many other types of birds are free and should not be locked up in a cage, as they were protected and were allowed to be free. The birds we all know that fly around where we live keep the land and the gardens clean, so that we and the land are healthy. That is why we feed the birds in winter, so that they have enough to eat when it's cold. The zookeeper in the bird aviary told Lawrence and Eden about a Chinese emperor who captured once a blackbird and put him in a cage so that he could sing only for the emperor. But the blackbird was always free and lost his voice and the will to sing because he was locked up. When the Chinese emperor let the blackbird out of the cage, the blackbird came and sat on top of the Chinese emperor's palace and sang not only for the Chinese emperor, but for everybody else as well, because the blackbird was now free again. I wouldn't like very much being in a cage myself, Lawrence said. It's nice to be free.